should we continue to keep money in fixed deposit? You see, this is the research that we have done, and according to the research, Maybank fixed deposit interest rate now at 1 month is paying about 1.5% per annum. And for 12 months, it is paying 1.85%. So we can safely say that it is not more than 2%. So for that matter, that is very low interest rate, and definitely you cannot beat inflation with such a low interest rate. And you also can't grow too much of your money with such a low interest rate. And Bank Negara continue to review the current situation, and they may even lower the interest rate further depending on the economy recovery situation. So for that matter, one option that we all can consider to increase the return of our fixed deposit money is to look for certain low risk investment but can give us higher, better return. So if I look at like Maybank 1 month FD rate just now, it is giving about 1.5% per annum. But if you were to invest into an instrument like what we call money market fund, historically, it can give you about 2.1%. And I believe even now, it's quite easy for them to give you about 2% per annum as well. So if you look at it, it's not so much, it's only 0.5% extra. But 0.5% out of 1.5%, that is 33% extra return that you are generating by moving your money from FD to money market fund. And of course, FD, you put it 100% into the bank deposit. This money market fund, the fund manager basically invests this money into some kind of paper, which is also cash and cash equivalent. Of course, as far as dividend is concerned, this FD, they will give you the dividend or the interest upon maturity. For money market fund, it's monthly distributed, but it depends on the ability of the income. And for redemption, you know that FD, you can redeem it very fast. You can redeem it the day itself. But if you put it for 1 year and you on the 11th month or the second or on the 10th month, you want to withdraw the money, they may give you the money immediately fast, but you may need to forego some part of the interest because for the penalty. But for money market fund, there is no maturity period. You can withdraw it anytime. The liquidity is available. Could be like T plus one day. If you say today you go and do the withdrawal, tomorrow money will go to your bank, or T plus two, meaning that 2 days later. So this is a comparison between fixed deposit, and if you were to put money into money market, it will give you higher return without taking too much of risk. And what are the benefits of money market fund? This is the benefit. So any individual or any corporate invest into money market fund, it is tax exempted. It will provide better return, and there's no lock-in period. There's no entry fee or exit fee. Normally, the sales charge for money market fund compared to equities, they may charge you 4%, 5% to enter an equity fund. But for money market fund, normally it is zero entry fee. And it's quite resilient because there is a regular income inside this particular instrument. And these are the example of the money market fund. Most fund houses offer money market funds. Of course, for a investment planner, financial advisor like us, on our platform, on our shelf, we have a list of the fund, different money market fund to offer to the client. If we look at the performance, we can see these are all performing differently. But we can see that generally, if we average it, most of it is doing, I would say, 2 to 3% quite easily.
If money is important to you, please remember to subscribe to my channel.